Adventure. I've actually never played the SNES one. Defaults to normal. Yeah, me too, Josh. I did not expect that this game was released after Diddy Kong Racing. Very surprising. Like, how did we end up with this game? It wasn't a character we knew. We didn't play the SNES ones. I'm letting the story play out for you guys. Pretty sure it's skippable. Great job. Yeah, I mean, different studios. Rare was just always amazing. I mean, think about the first Rare game we played was probably Donkey Kong Country. It was so good. Oh, yeah, for sure. And yeah, Chris, there are a few on SNES. All right. Sorry, I have Twitter on the other screen. How Kiro managed to drop a box of Cheez-Its in the toilet? Only Kiro. La, 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 la. Yeah, there were definitely more in Japan. Bomberman was a series that was more popular in Japan, like Mystical Ninja. You got a bone to pick with them? Because of the force field, there's no way you'd be able to get near, let alone get in, comma, the central base. Dude, So, Donkey Kong 64 is probably... It's in my top three biggest disappointments for games. I don't know, like, the speedrunning order for this, so I'm just... gonna be doing this off... whatever. Oh my god. Yes, I know. Yeah. Thanks, man. I know. Been playing too many mobile games. There's always like a skip tutorial button. I need that. Should have watched the speedrun before this. Let's see. Oh, it's on this side, yeah. Oh yeah, here we go. Donkey Kong Country 2 was incredible. Yeah, see, my issue with DK64 is just that it wasn't Donkey Kong Country. It was a completely different game. And I just wasn't into it. It was too complicated of a collectathon for me to like it. Like, I dealt with Banjo-Kazooie, you know, I liked it, but the character switching and all that you had to do in DK64 and, like, the sheer amount of crap you had to find and collect, I don't know. It lost me. I don't know what... I wasn't paying attention to what that just did. Yeah, same. Yeah, Metroid Prime, definitely. I just wasn't as into it because I wanted Super Metroid and I didn't get that. Instead, I got this game where I was supposed to scan a million things. Oh, crap. Oh. And that's why I never got into the sequels. I played Prime 2 until the memory card corrupted, and then I lost interest. I didn't want to redo it. Fusion? Yeah, man. Fusion is pretty freaking cool. Oh yeah, it's the heart. I was like, what is this thing? Fusion was a pretty legit game. Maybe I should walk across first. Oh, that's, I want you. I liked Fusion Zero Mission, and then I actually haven't played the remake that they did for Metroid 2, but I did play AM2R, which I liked a lot. My issue with Fusion, Josh, is that it's like way more linear than Super Metroid. Like, there's no real exploring. You just do exactly what it tells you to do. Like, there's a computer telling you where to go and what to do the whole time. You have the remake, you haven't played it yet? Have you played AM2R? Zero Mission is nice. I mean, it's just a better version of the original. The original is hard to play, man. Like, no map, no saves. No thanks. Oh, you should definitely play AM2R. It's so good, man. But then Nintendo went and made one of their own. Oh, do I need the gold cards? No, I don't, to beat the game. Metroid 1 is balls. Yeah, dudes. Oh, I missed him. I think I get one for... Didn't you get one for bouncing on his head? I mean, even the original Metroid 2 is hard to play. Yeah, Chris, this guy I know through Frisbee, he's an NES speedrunner, White Hat. He has records on for like 60-something games on speedrun.com. He just plays NES games, though. I don't know, some of the platformers are not... They don't look too bad. But most of the games, yeah, I'm with you. Don't remember what order I'm supposed to do anything. I wasn't paying attention to where the stupid thing went. I know I have to go there eventually. Some NES games have decent platforming, but I mean, most of them just, yeah, it's... Unless you're just like blinded by nostalgia, they don't hold up that well. Oh, come here. Oh, baby. Oh, okay. Oh, nice. You know, so there's a Metroid 2 hack for NES where it, like, adds a map and stuff to it. Or Metroid 1. Maybe both. But that seems pretty cool. That, like, huge quality of life change. Oh. And yeah, Mega Man, for sure. Mega Man 1's kind of hard to play. 2 is good. No, I mean, there were just some games where it was like, okay, you guys put way more time and effort into these, into this game. And it shows. Oh, I didn't change the game number on my overlay. We're on game 36, baby. I wasn't looking. Where did that go? I should really pay attention. Oh my god, am I stuck? That was kind of funny, though. Get up there! Oh, it's up there? How do I get up there? God. Yay, I did it. The Zelda games. So the Zelda games are going to be interesting because I've never played them. I played Ocarina, like the first couple hours of it, a few times, but that's it. Jimmy Joe's really excited for me to play them on stream because I'll like be discovering everything for the first time. Oh, come on. Come back here. Game over. But I won. Majora is one of my favorite games. Yeah. I think Ocarina is the most popular, but I think Majora, most people consider, like, objectively the better game. So I only have one. I don't have a heart here. What's the strat? Yeah, yeah. Ocarina is a more traditional Zelda game. Majora's is like kind of tough, right? With the like dealing with the moon and all that crap. I don't know. I've never played it, and I've never watched a run of it. So I actually like super noob. I actually avoid those GDQ runs because I know I'm gonna play it at some point. I'll hit this guy eventually. It expects you've played Ocarina before. Oh, okay, interesting. I guess when I was calling it hard, I was... Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. Dude, I just... Never thought about that. Dude, I just like murdered a whole building of people. It's pretty messed up. Man, the real terrorist. Yeah, dude, I just blew up a building and all these people just died. Like, pretty messed up. I mean, I guess they're all supposed to be bad guys, but dude, they were just like at home living their life. Bomberman's the boogeyman. He just shows up in the middle of the night while you're sleeping. Bomberman is legend. It's like the whole like theme behind I Am Legend, but it's like completely lost in the movie because they don't talk about it. Like you finish the movie and you're like, why was that called I Am Legend again? Switch somewhere that I can now access because there's no water. Yeah. Gotta go soon, but I'm gonna go to snow, so I wanna play Mario. Oh, Mario Party! Dude, I thought you were asking about doubles. Do you mean Mario Party for 64 or for Switch or another console? Because I'm always down to play Mario Party 2 because it's better than 3. Crap, what did that Switch just do? I wasn't paying attention. Did he do something over here? So either, yeah. Alright. You prefer 3? I used to. But now, after playing a bunch of 3 and 2, I feel like 2 has less random stuff in it. There are some aspects of 3 I like better. Like that you can have multiple items. How do I talk to you? But yeah. What it comes down to for me is just like less, I feel like there's less random stuff in 2. Also I think overall I like the mini games in 2 better. Sweet if someone could make a ROM hack Mario Party that has all of the mini games from both, and you can have multiple items. Oh, Waluigi. Yeah, I don't really care about Waluigi. But yeah, dude, I'm down. I'll play 3. It's been a long time. Really, like, only play 2 for the last like few years. Go back up, back up, Artemis. Whoa, that was no heart. Don't you? Yo. Oh, it goes through the wall. Josh, his cask go through the wall. It goes through the pillar. Party XX would be awesome. Friday night we might do Draft Cruise, but I would also be down for Mario Party, obviously. Also, I get in really late Thursday night, so I might be down for stuff Thursday night if you're around. Some remote bombs. Yeah, Draft Cruise. I think that's what we want to do with Friday night. Just not sure if it'll happen. Hi, Libby. Yeah. You can let him in here. If you're going to sleep, just close the bedroom door and he can come in here. Hey, Bert. All right, guys, Bert's here. It's a party now. Dude, blowing up that whole building should have given me remote mines. I don't think it's asking too much. You won't be around Thursday night? Alright. But yeah, Friday night, Draft Cruise is the plan. But, I mean, after that. I'm always down for something that takes way too long, like Mario Party or Mario Golf. Where are you going? Is that Princess Peach? Aw. Oh, yeah, I forgot. You rotate the joystick in Bomberman to get out of stun. Nah. Where am I supposed to go? Got some stuff to do now. Good luck with Bomberman. Thanks, man. Thanks for stopping by. Always good to see you. Yeah, what the hell am I supposed to do? Oh. Like there was space there. Oh, some custom gear. That's what the people really want. Thank you. collecting all the gold cards here. And I don't care. Three gold cards. Oh yeah, fish boss. I know you can like throw one in his mouth. There are like ways you can cheese him. I just don't remember. That does that mean he won't do that attack anymore? That he does his butt fan attack. Butt fin attack part 2. Come on, let me throw it in your mouth. Just let me do it. Oh, this is the big wave. Whoa. Run against the wave. Dude, come on. Stayed here. Bomberman, Breaker of Chains. So those guys just don't die. Gold card. I'm gonna say yes, it was. So let's go down here. I just like. I feel like I just skipped the whole level. I'll take it. Mini boss time. Just like I drew it up. Damn, he just explodes. Armin's a murderer. She's out here killing people. Bomberman's gonna take longer than Automobili. Oh, okay, you go this way. Can I go this way? Or something awesome. Oh. At least they don't mix it up with these directions too much. They stick with the gate, what the gate does. Thank you. solid soundtrack. Alright, that's just nothing. Was all that just nothing? Great, because you can just hold forward and just change the camp. Oh, okay. I remember that one now. Nothing? Alright. Guess I need to find a switch somewhere. But where? Ow. Couldn't remember what the max was. I guess it's 8. Should there be fire coming out of this? It's red. Thank you. So what the hell is that other thing I found? Oh man, only one more minute until we catch Lamborghini. Dude, come on. Let's just forget that happened. Alright. Why can't I run away from that? Look how happy he is. Breaker of chains. Definitely not looking forward to these levels. I gotta get all my stats back now. Bow. Oh, it's not enough. Darn. Game over. What happens when I run out of credits? I want to find out. I'm scared. Really? A snowman takes multiple hits from a bomb. I don't agree with this. I didn't realize I could just walk up. It's pretty silly. Yeah, take that, house. Crap. I had to abort very quickly. It's about to blow up. Alright, blow up the house. So there's that. Holding out for heart or remote bombs. Protected by the mountain? Ooh. No, I didn't know there was an edge there. Oh, come on. That was just unfair. Alright, something is supposed to make the lift come to me. Let's go check out this house. Ooh.
Regulus.
Guy's head. Oh, come on. Could have gotten that fifth gold card. Alright, ice level, everyone's favorite. Ah, yes. The slippery ice floor on the 3D platformer. Definitely everybody's favorite. Can't wait for. There's like one part that I know has like a super narrow path. This was fun. Like, we totally needed this. Thanks, Bomberman. I'm so glad I had to do that. Oh, Nintendo, you're so innovative. Wow, time's already up. Times are tight for these gold cards. Bommy boy. What's up, AK? How's it going? Glad to see you again. Well, here's that super narrow path I was talking about. Thank you, Nintendo. Not even a thing I had to do. Oh, that's extra annoying. How's Bomberman 64 going? It's going all right. I have this level and the boss of this world, and then I'm on the final world. So, moving right along. Dude, freaking ice. And I'm gonna disagree with you there. You don't gotta love them. Definitely not. Like, I can't even line up my shot, right? How do I get on the other side? They're so fun and forgiving. Yep, that's when I think of an ice stage, I think fun and forgiving. Those are definitely the two things that come to mind first. So actually, if you get really good with the camera, you don't have to actually turn. So you can just like hold forward. Alright, so last time I went fancy. Stupid gold card. I'm gonna waste all that time. Ready for Ice Spider? Well, like, I didn't know I was going for a gold card till the end. Because I'm not going for all gold cards. I'm just going to beat the game. Oh, you, wow, you never played the Rainbow Palace or whatever? Those levels are a lot more complicated. Man, I remember spending hours on some of these levels. Just like trying to see if I could discover everything. With like bomb jumps and stuff, because you like you couldn't really just look it up. There weren't all these nice like walkthroughs and everything. You've seen a TAS? That's cool. I've never seen TAS. I've seen speedruns like on GDQ. See, younger me did have the patience. Older me does not. And it was always just like seeing if we could discover things. Because there weren't all these like detailed guides. Oh, son of a... I just remember seeing the speedrun where he just stood underneath the spider the whole time. So I'm trying it. Take that, spider. Yeah, some of those MMOs, you're just like, I can't find this thing, and you don't want to just spend 20 minutes looking for it. So you're like, all right, WoW head, where you at? Falling through the ice, falling through the web as the ice falls. Oh, that's so wrong. I was really hoping that wouldn't happen to me just now. Alright, I do not remember. I supposed to bomb bounce? Like the first stage where it's necessary. Just want to beat it. Wait, is this just repeating itself? You mother. I put myself in a bad spot. I wouldn't say that's all luck. Okay. That's dumb. Alright, just get me out of here. So I don't think it ever puts two cars in the same. No, never mind. So much for that theory. I guess I do have to actually do stuff up here. Freaking buses, man. Oh, I can't wait to get dive bombed by these freaking. They're just. There's nothing over here. That's fun. Oh, that's a cheap move, man. As I'm sneezing? Ooh. Oh yeah, this looks familiar. Fine. Yes. Really want that. Oh, fun. Oh, that's just a one hit. Oh, that's cool. I have no more credits. What happens? What happens if I lose? I don't know. Am I gonna do the rainbow levels? Probably not, because it's extra. Like, just beating this world, it is an ending. So I think it counts. So I guess you did have to go through a few times. The red one that's the last one? Yeah. Mother. It's just stuck. Now, because Josh, to do the, if I was doing the rainbow one, I would have to get all the gold cards. So that's like 100%. Piece of crap. Oh, come on! Same place twice? Well, about to find out what happens when you hit zero credits. Not get long out. No, come on. What is that? What happens? when you run out of continues, it just, you're like, haha, you have to go back to the title screen. I'll screw you. No! It didn't hit me. That did not actually hit me. I called BS. So not fair. No. Whew, whew. Not the title screen. Yeah, that's the big punishment, man. I got you used up all your continues. You got game over. Back to the title screen. Maybe a little more. Some wussy bombs. Yeah, alright, man. Forget that guy's name. No, isn't Altair the bad guy? Gotcha, idiot. I just wasn't even looking at that. Oh, I suck. Serious. Huh. I would not have guessed that. Did you ever play any of the other Bombermans for 64? Because I did not. Oof, that went a lot further than I thought it would. That was, like, not hard. Yeah, I didn't play Second Attack, and I didn't play Hero. Ultra. This is actually the only Bomberman game I've ever played. I think I've played, like, the original at, like, a bar before, but that's it.
Oh, yeah, this guy.
This does. I got greedy. Greedy, greedy. Rotate the stick to get out of stuns. Yeah, that's, they either say it at the beginning of the game or it's in the instruction manual. Back in the day, you used to actually, like, read the instruction manual. A lot of useful things in there. That's how I know how to recalibrate the joystick. A lot of people don't know that. They're like, oh, I have to unplug and replug my controller back in. It's like, no, no you don't. Hold R and L and press start. Oh, come on. Instructions, garage sales. Yeah, that's fair. If you're getting them from, like, a yard sale, they're not going to have it. I guess even, like, GameStop or Funko Land or whatever didn't have it either because they just had loose cartridges. Some instruction manuals were clutch. Like, they had a map or something in it. Like, that was pretty awesome. Like, I never would have... Well, eventually, but... Would have been way harder to beat some games without the map. I'm guessing that blows up. Alright. Two copies of Mario World. Decent game to have two copies of. Are you into Super Mario World ROM hacks very much, AK? Playing or watching? Because a new one got released a couple weeks ago, and it's amazing. It's called Grand Poo World 2. Yeah, dude. This one, Grand Poo World. Oh, I'm an idiot. Of course it's going to do that. It's incredible. Highly recommend checking it out. You're going to lose a lot if you just watch a speedrun of it. Because it has, like, puzzles and things that you obviously won't figure out if you just watch a speedrun. Oh, there's just nothing. That's cool. Oh, I can't go straight anymore. That dodge, see that dodge? Oh man. The Kaiser, yeah. Grand Poo World is just like, it has all the, you know, the crazy Kaizo stuff. It has puzzles. The soundtrack is amazing. It's just, it's so good. Like, the level design is really good. It has like little aesthetic things, like, you know, there's a cave level, and it gets darker every time you go deeper. And, like, I don't know. It's just, it's so good. And it's not, like, insanely difficult like some of the Kaizos. You know, you're not doing, like, 50 shell jumps or something. Yeah, it's very cool. Watching the guy who it's named after, Grand Pooh Bear, watching his first playthrough of it was really fun, because he like has to discover everything, and he wasn't allowing his chat to spoil anything. Yeah, the team for this game, for this hack, put in over 1,000 hours on it. There was a lot of testing, and it's really well made. But yeah, I totally hear you on that. Like, some hacks, you're just like, what the hell are you doing, man? Oh yeah, Mario Maker. People just make these levels, and you're just like, they're such trolls. Oh, it's a heart. So it's not made by him, But yeah, based on the name, you'd think. It's made by this guy, Barbarian DK or something. Just goes by Barb. But that's who made it. Him and a team. Definitely not just him. He's like the main designer and everything, but he had a guy that did all the sound mixing and stuff. He had testers. It was a team. But yeah, very cool. I don't know why I waited the last one. Yeah, the part was rough. That I just lost on. Not too excited about it. Is that enough? Guess so. Kind of a funny enemy. They just forklift you. Yeah, I don't play them, the ROM hacks, but I enjoy watching. Especially ones like this that have a good soundtrack. Still going up? No, we're going down. Does the madness ever end? Bomber 64 TAS. Yeah, even the non-TAS, even like the speedrunners have some pretty cool tricks that they do. They like intentionally hit themselves and stuff. Ah, crap. Get back up there. I don't remember which one I came from. Thank you. Alright, this level getting a little silly. Did I just do all of that for a heart? At least if I screw up a laser now, I don't just lose. Alright, that was a little annoying. God, this was just extra. It was all just extra. No, this makes me sad. So much time wasted. So I actually did have to beat that stupid little puzzle thing. That makes me even more annoyed. I was scared to try and walk off. Don't recall having to do the big grid. Man. Wait, how do I get the elevator back? Like waiting for something crazy to happen. And nothing's happening. Oh my god. Idiot. Well, because the other one, it like threw me backwards. So I thought this might do the same. Oh my god. Do I have to like redo? Let's get the elevator back. Go through this. This one stage is gonna take me as long as the rest of the game. Just a gold card. Yeah. Alright, that's all that's here. So I'm definitely missing something. At least it's a fun stage. I'm over it. I want it to end. So this was the only button. And so like the next logical place for just following a nice linear path is here. Here. So much to do, so much to see. So you're not just singing All Star? So we hit one. And one gave us this. So, nothing. There is something going on here. We can't get there. Two. respawn rate. Two sends us this way to hit four. Us that Okay. No way. That actually worked? There wasn't just a switch? No wonder you didn't remember the grid. Yeah, because you didn't have to. No. Oh, that was so stupid. Oh, now I have no lives. Oh my god. No extra lives, no heart, no remote bombs. Just a bomber man in a dream. Dude, the camera angle got me, man. I was like, oh, just walk to the end. It's right there. It's right there. Oh, yes. Oh yeah, press R to stop bouncing and kick. It's like pretty important. I think this guy's pretty tough. I don't know. I don't remember.
You wanna bite me?
You wanna fight me? Too bad. You gotta fight me and my ship. Oh, he doesn't even give me a remote. I just have to drop bombs and hope he runs into him. This isn't even my final form.
I'll finish you.
Oh. Thank you. I was gonna get the throw. Now I'm trying to style on him. I want to throw him off the edge. Really bad. Oh wait, there's another world after this. I forgot. Right? I thought, is it just this and then the rainbow? He got away, but that can't be helped. Okay, so it's just the rainbow world, though, right? Okay. All right. Yo, serious? That's so funny. Yo, underrated song. The Bomberman 64 credits? Who knew? This would be a great song to use for like a team introduction video. Where like, I picture like during that little part, it's like people's names pop up. I don't know, it's in my head. Yeah, Bomberman 64 music was pretty good. I commented on that a few times. That was nice. Then we knocked out two games tonight. Next on the list is Chameleon Twist. I don't know if I really want to start playing it tonight. I might end early. Yeah, Blue Resort music is really good. The like mountain music, it's like more just kind of like ominous, like ambient stuff. Yeah, Blue Resort has solid music. Oh, I remember in the credits, we got to watch, like it shows you some little secrets. That was how we found some things. Because we beat the game the first time. And then we watched the credits, and it showed you. And then that, like, really, like, opened the door. And we're like, wait, there are all these other things we can find. I don't know. I was like, I remember that. That was a moment. Like, bouncing up the pillar on that first level. Oh, I spent hours trying to get that. Josh, do you remember how much time we spent on the very first level, like trying to unlock all the secrets and like find everything? Just on the first level. Yeah, that was like frame perfect dashback. Look at this guy. Too much time. Yeah, so much time. If it had been like a slightly older version of us, we would have gotten it insanely faster. Yeah, I mean, we didn't unlock, or we didn't like find all of the custom armor pieces. Like I've watched not 100% runs, but all gold card runs But I've never seen a run that where they got all of the armor pieces, I don't think. I'm just going to let this roll. See, like, it shows you these little tidbits. There's a lot of stuff in Green Garden, man. The guy that got away. Let this roll. I'll be right back. Make sure Bert's okay. Dude, it's still going? Pick up every curse in battle. Look at that level. Dude, there's so much in here. This has got to be almost over. These are some long credits. Yeah, I mean, this is a very slow way to show them. But I'm committed now. Gotta let it play out. Oh, you could have just done a regular bomb? I did the big boy. Kind of weird though. It's like, hey, you beat the game, but not really. Here's all the secrets you missed. So we're up to game number 37. Chameleon Twist. Link to the past Ganon will tell you where the arrows are. So AK, how did you end up in this stream? Are you a Smash person that I know? I can't remember. You watch a lot of Smash Bros. Don't play competitively? Oh, okay. Not at all? It's interesting. For someone to watch a lot of Smash 64 but not play. Like, I could see that for the other ones. Oh, hey, Rainbow Palace. But I feel like that's very rare for 64. Oh, that's actually not in the soda line. Check that out. Alright, so we have Chameleon Twist and then FIFA. No! No! Oh, it's just something I never want to see. Freaking FIFA. So unfortunate. My favorite games so far have been sports games. Yeah, okay. Wayne Gretzky was awesome. But let's look back at the football, basketball, and soccer games that I've played. So all of the sports games that are not Wayne Gretzky. Oh wait, hey. The credits are like almost finally. Oh, it's because it shows Sirius and he's bad. Stay tuned.